Remember early in the course, we measured the average speed of a bullet which we fired from a rifle. That was because we had the ability of very fast timing. In the old days, fast timing was not possible, and people measured the speed of bullets in a very delicate way. And all the tools that we have learned, we can apply now to this device which we call the ballistic pendulum. We have a pendulum with a very heavy object hanging here at the end. I call it the block. You see it here. And this pendulum has length L. Ours is about 1 meter. I will give you the exact numbers later. And we have a bullet of mass little m. And the bullet comes in with velocity V, gets completely absorbed, sticks in there. It's a completely inelastic collision. And the pendulum will then pick up a velocity V prime with the bullet inside. The bullet is somewhere here. Momentum is conserved, so we clearly have that mv equals m plus m times v prime. So if you could measure v prime, then you could measure the speed of the bullet, which is v. How do we measure v prime? Well, we wait for the pendulum to come to a halt, let's say here, when the speed is zero. When it was here, it had a speed v prime. And we know that there was kinetic energy here, no gravitational potential energy. I can call this level u equals zero. But right here, if this difference in height is h, then all the kinetic energy has been converted to gravitational potential energy. So we apply the theorem, the work energy theorem, or you could say it's equally valid. You could say we apply the conservation of mechanical energy. And so this kinetic energy, which is 1/2 m plus m times v prime squared, is now converted exclusively to gravitational potential energy, which equals m plus m times g times that h. And we lose our m plus m. So v prime would be the square root of 2gh. And so all you would have to measure h, and then you know v prime. And if you know v prime, you know the speed of the bullet. But life is not that simple. It's very difficult to measure h, and I can make you see that. Suppose this angle, angle theta, when it comes to a halt, is only 2 degrees. Then h, which is L times 1 minus cosine theta, is only 0.6 millimeters for the dimensions that I have chosen here, for a length of 1 meter. And that's it. You can't even see it. It's invisible, let alone that you can measure it to any degree of accuracy. So what are we going to do now? Well, we are going to not measure h, but we are going to measure x. I call this x equals 0. And here, when the pendulum comes to a halt, I call that x. For a 2-degree angle, x is approximately 3.5 centimeters. Can easily be checked by you, of course. So you get a huge displacement in this direction compared to h. If you use small angle approximation, and you better believe it, 2 degrees is very small, then you can prove, which is purely geometrical mathematics, and I leave you with that proof, that this is approximately x squared divided by 2L. I want you to prove that. You take the expansion of the cosine series, of the Taylor series, and you cut it off somewhere, and this is not so difficult to prove. In other words, v prime squared, which is 2gh, can now be replaced by approximately 2g times x squared divided by 2l, which is g times x squared divided by l. And so the velocity of the bullet, v, which is m plus m divided by m, I bring the m down there, times v prime, but v prime is now the square root of this, so I get an x here times the square root of g over l. And what you see now, that in a very clever way, by getting x in here, we can now do a quite accurate measurement of the speed of this bullet, because we can measure x with a fair accuracy. Maybe an uncertainty of only 1 or 2 millimeters in x out of the 3.5 or 4 or 5 centimeters. We're going to measure the speed of such a bullet. We did that before. We should get a number which is not too different. I think we got something like 200 to 250 meters per second. I will give you the input for this experiment. The bullet mass is 2 plus or minus 0.2 grams. I apologize that I don't give you all the numbers in MKS units. You will have to convert them, of course, to MKS units. The length of the pendulum is 1.13 meters plus or minus 2 centimeters. We're not certain. It's an accuracy of about 2 centimeters. And the mass of that block, which is huge, I believe is 3,200 grams, 3.2 kilograms, with an uncertainty of about 2 grams. So we have a 10% uncertainty in the mass. We have a 2% uncertainty in the length. And we have a negligible uncertainty in the mass of the block. That's negligibly small. So if I want to know now what the velocity is of the speed of the bullet, I can calculate what m plus m divided by m is. I can calculate the square root of g over l. And with those numbers, I find 4.7 times 10 to the third times x. We have to measure x. Now, if you look at the uncertainties in the whole thing, we're going to measure x, which may not be 3.5 centimeters. It may be 4 or 5. But the uncertainty in our measurements will probably be 1 or 2 millimeters. Let's say it's 0.2 centimeters. So this is not our real number yet. So that would be an uncertainty of about 2 out of 50. It's 4 out of 100. It's 4%. This is 4%, roughly 4%. So I would say we get the final speed of the bullet to an accuracy of about 15% if we combine all the uncertainties. So let's give it a shot, no pun implied. And we can make you see the pendulum right there very shortly. And it is very cleverly designed. When the pendulum starts to swing, it's going to move a small object. There you have it. I think I can turn this on again. I think that's fine. There is a very small wiper, which is this black wiper. And as the pendulum swings, this is 5 centimeters, this is 10 centimeters, the wiper will stay at the largest extension when the pendulum swings back. Okay, when we fire bullets, it's always a little risky. I have here the bolt. Put the bolt in. The bullet's in my pocket. There's one. That's right. There comes the bullet. And I cock the gun. Everything done right, yes. So you can look there and then see the swing of this very massive block, and the bullet will get absorbed in that block. You ready for this? 3, 2, 1, 0. I would say 5.2 centimeters. seems to me about right. So x observed is about 5.2 centimeters. And we know the uncertainty of the 15% already. So I have to calculate now the 4.7 times 10 to the third, 4.7 exponent third, multiply by, I go MKS, of course, so that is 0.052, and that is 244 meters per second. I remember last time we had something very similar. So the speed of the bullet is about 244 meters per second. It's a little under the speed of sound, which is 340 meters per second. And we came to the same conclusion last time. All right. We had kinetic energy in the bullet before the bullet hit the block. And you can calculate how much that is, because you know the speed now, and you know the mass. 1/2 mv². You can also calculate how much kinetic energy there is when this bullet is absorbed in here. That's very easy. That's 1/2 times the total mass, m plus m, times v², which you also know now. And so you will see then, perhaps to your surprise, that if you compare the two, that 99.94% of all available kinetic energy before the collision was destroyed and therefore was converted to heat. That happened, of course, the heat was produced in that block.